All right, next up we have John Hickey, who is here from 1968 to 1971.
You have your speaker. Yes, I don't have it on my iPhone. This is your first test. Okay, do the students all know that? That's Led Zeppelin. Imagine the quad, first time the song came out. Blasting on the quad. Now, in the old days, we didn't have the internet. So if you liked the song, you had to go to the record store and sing the song to the cashier. And the cashiers knew all the songs, so they bring you the record, you buy it, and you have to take it back to your room, put it on the stereo, bring your friends in and sit down and listen to the song on the stereo. Okay, I'm from Washington, D.C., and I'm here to help you. Thank you for taking time out of your busy and glamorous lives and listening to us boring old people. It's great to be back in Farley Hall, home of the finest women in the world. Touring the dorm this weekend, I was very impressed with you all and the community you have here. I came back to Farley because it means a lot to me. I promise to make this the most dramatic speech ever. I'm going to tell you a love story, and then we're going to stage a love-in for world peace. I lived in Farley from 68 to 71, and if you were to go back to that time, you would be on a different planet. Can we bring a slide up? Are you there? Go on to the next one. For example, this is a 1969 photo of a woman who's currently running for president of the United States. Here on campus, we smoked in the dorm rooms. We decorated our rooms with these psychedelic blacklight posters going to the next room. We had mandatory Saturday classes. And up to 1970, Notre Dame refused to play in bowl games. Really? We did not have smartphones. The Facebook was a real book. And of course, there were no women. I only have one picture of Farley Hall. Can we go on to the next one? One more. Okay. That's the last one. This is my girlfriend, future wife, Marcella. She went to the University of Maryland. She is sitting over the entrance outside of room 219. Is the people from 219 here? Great, awesome. Were you there when I was there last night? Your roommate's showing you that room last night. Now, you might be asking yourself, is this a parietals violation? Yes, it is. In those days, girls were only allowed in the dorms on football Saturdays. That was it. Now, on Saturday night, what time do the parietals end now?
2 a.m.
Is that enough time to conduct your research? Okay, now seniors. I know you don't need any more stress. By the way, I found out that's Farley Hall's favorite word, stress. Are there any seniors here who are engaged? That's not stress. Any seniors here who are engaged? No, okay. Well, back then when you were dating, you were thinking about getting married. And last night I met Kelly, who is in room 414. I don't think she was here, but she was nice enough to show me her room. And I proposed to my wife in room 414. Again, we were up there violating parietals. A lot of violations went on. Not only did I propose to Marcella, but we got married during my senior year of football season. I spent Thursday night in Farley Hall. I got up on Friday. I went to class on my wedding day. Can we have the next slide?
Yep.
Okay. We got married in the log chapel that Friday night because you are not allowed to get married on football Saturdays. We were married by Father Schultz, the rector, and by my dear friend Father Griffin, who the Keenan Hall Griffins are named after. He was a wonderful man. We spent our wedding night in a hotel, and then we went to the game on Saturday, and then we moved into our apartment off campus. Okay? Stress. I made my wife, Marcella, a fake St. Mary's student ticket with a football, with a Polaroid camera so we could go to all the football games today. It's a lot easier to make fake tickets back then. We've been married for 44 years, and Marcella's father also went to Notre Dame. She was not able to be here today due to a family obligation, but she did want to be here. And if I could offer you some marriage advice, you've heard a lot about marrying your best friend. No, that's wrong. You have a lot of best friends right here. Don't marry them. Marry a guy that you're passionate about, who's crazy in love with you. You want your husband to wake up every morning and go, "Yay, I'm married to her." Now, this 68-71 period was a time of historical, social, and political revolution. This was the peak of the civil rights movement. Martin Luther King was assassinated in 1968. The first man walked on the moon in 1969. A month later was the Woodstock Music Festival. Notre Dame elected its first African-American student body president. The correct term then was Afro-American. We referred to African-Americans as Afro-Americans. Time magazine selected everyone under 25 years old as persons of the year, so you can put that on your resume. Women's liberation was just beginning, which led to Notre Dame going co-ed and Farley becoming a women's dorm. Now, it wasn't because they wanted to give equal opportunities to women, it was because the male students wanted to have women on campus. There was still a widespread view throughout the country that women should not go to graduate school and should not have jobs. The gay rights movement was very limited, so gay people stayed in the closet. The Vietnam War and peace demonstrations were at a peak. We call this the Age of Aquarius. Now what we're going to do is we're going to conduct a love-in. And so I need four student volunteers to come up. Here, bring some of your friends up here.
This is Notre Dame.
Notre Dame love bees. Shirts. Okay. These are original protest shirts. And all those of you who are these symbolize that we were on strike for peace. They still have my original laundry tags. And this was a good way to meet hot hippie boys. But it was also very serious, because when we graduated, we were all going to get drafted into the military and sent to the Vietnam War. That meant that all your boyfriends and all your brothers were going to be going to war. And if the draft comes back, you women will also be subject to the draft. Also, college girls went brawlers. That's okay. That was part of women's liberation. But the fad did not last very long because Madonna came along and blew it out of the way. Not only did she wear one, but she wore it on the outside. Okay, that completes our... Can we get our picture? Yes.
Can I get more? There I go. Peace sign, please.
Heavy man. We could get one more. I've got my own.
Excuse me.
See, that's part of the 60s too.
Get away from the towers.
Stay away from the brown acid.
If, Sarah, can would you mind taking a picture? You're better at it than me, probably.
Far out.
Okay. Look at the camera. Flower power. You can keep it, Heather.
Thank you. Thank you.
The shirts are valuable as much as I am. Okay, now, I have a good Father Hesper story. This is a secret. Nobody knows about this. You probably know that he was the original Farley Hall rector in the 40s before he became president. I don't know. Oh, he probably wasn't in Farley then.
Father Barry was the first in 47.
But Hesper was at one time, right?
He
lived here. Hesper lived here anyway. So, in 1971, on Good Friday night, there was about 20 Farleyites still in the dorm because everybody else went home for Easter. And my girlfriend, my future wife Marcella, was visiting, and she was the only girl. That was pretty common. It was kind of hard, and there weren't very many girls around. So it was kind of hard for the girls. It was sort of like the girl in Hunger Games going into the campus. So she was here visiting, and we were having a party up on the second floor, listening to acid rock music, and we were drinking freely. And one of the guys who had been drinking a lot said, let's go see Father Ted. And everybody said, you know, it's 10 o'clock at night, Father Ted isn't gonna see us. So he gets on the phone while we're all sitting there listening to the stereo, and he calls over to the administration building, and the guard answers. And he talks to the guard, and the guy hands up the phone and says, Father Ted says to come on over. So the 20 of us, including my girlfriend, all marched over to the administration building at 10 o'clock at night. And the guard let us in, and we went up to his office, and he warmly greeted us and shook hands with everybody. Nobody had ever been in his office. And we were very impressed that he had a TV and a stereo. A priest has a TV and a stereo. And he was listening to a controversial new musical called Jesus Christ Superstar. Have you heard of that? So that's why it was cool to go to school at this time. And we were all like, wow, this is really cool. Father Ted is listening to Jesus Christ Superstar. And it was a great evening, and Father Ted was a great man. He talked to us about speeches he was writing and trips he had taken, and he was just really nice. And when Marcella told her parents that she had met Father Ted, they just couldn't believe it. It might as well have been the Pope. And nobody knows that this happened. Nobody had a camera. No Facebook to go, hey, we all met Father Ted. No. So I have a suggestion. Next week, call Father Jenkins and tell him you're all coming home. Now, I'd like to leave you with some challenges. These are my secrets to success. Number one, stay sober. Number two, learn to speak Spanish. And number three, don't ever let anybody get away with disrespecting women. Next year, have a 60s theme party. Thank you. This has been a great weekend, and thank you for keeping the Farley dream alive.